The year is 2016. Kanye West has released The Life of Pablo to wide acclaim. We've already lost Prince and a princess. Mos Def has retired from music. The unlisted link for Lemonade is quickly making the rounds. April 25th, Drake tweets this image announcing the next annual OVO Fest. This will be the seventh OVO Fest since its inception in 2010, just a year after Drake's mixtape, So Far Gone, catapulted him into the mainstream. Across the life of the festival, it's featured huge names alongside Drake, including music mentor Lil Wayne, popular collaborators J. Cole and A$AP Rocky, early OVO affiliate The Weeknd, and OVO artist Party Next Door. Already having attended in 2012 and 2015, it's none other than Kanye West, a huge name notably absent from this year's roster. Fast forward to July 31st, 2016, Scotiabank Arena, downtown Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Crowds are beginning to form in anticipation for the 7th annual OVO Fest. As the lights finally come on, the night is opened by Division, before Drake takes to the stage with Future, performing some of the biggest tracks from Drake's 6-time platinum-selling album, Views. He opens up with the ultra-viral meme factory, Hotline Bling, bringing with it a theme of internet culture that will be present throughout Drake's entire OVO performance this year. The following night, Monday, August the 1st, a special guest is brought out to the crowd surprise. It's Kanye West. And this is where our story really begins. After performing the original version of Pop Style with Drake, complete with the Street Fighter 2 sample, Kanye performs some of his own records from his album, The Life of Pablo, including famous 2016's mega controversial comments on celebrity, menacing, notorious, and impossible to look away from. After the performances, something interesting happens, just in case Kanye's surprise attendance wasn't enough of a curveball. Before performing his distorted hip-hop gospel anthem, Father Stretch My Hands Part 1, Kanye gets to the mic and addresses the audience. Toronto, I got one question for you. Is y'all ready for this album? I wasn't talking about Pablo, I wasn't talking about Views. I want to ask y'all right now, are you ready for this album? Gesturing towards Drake. Drake later on confirms that he and Kanye are considering a collab. So, it looks like there's a collaborative album on the way. To assess the likelihood of this, let's go back through the timeline. When Drake first rose to prominence in 2009 with So Far Gone, you could argue that his main inspiration was Kanye West. The project sounds like it was crafted in honor of Kanye's 808s and Heartbreak, with the chilly feels and emotional lyrics. Later that year, Kanye produced Drake's track Find Your Love and directed the music video for Best I Ever Had. So, we know that their artistic relationship has strong foundations. But is this the first time they've mentioned a partnership? Actually, no. Fast forward now to 2015, in an interview with The Breakfast Club, Kanye West said the Wolves song came from a conversation that me and Drake had where we was gonna do an album together, and the album was called Wolves. Drake had mentioned it in the past too. In April 2016, during the Views episode of OVO Sound Radio, Drake shared that he and Kanye were working on music collaboratively. Drake said, "We have a great relationship. I hope we get more music out. We were supposed to do a mixtape together, an album together." Now fast forward to August 28, 2016, less than a month after the explosive suggestions were made on the stage at the Toronto Arena. A number of billboards pop up around the Los Angeles area. They're square, bright green, and massive. They read in white Helvetica, "Calabasas is the new Abu Dhabi," the rumored first song of the project. And below it, two logos. The logo on the left is a cherub with wings, the insignia of Kanye's record label, Good Music. And on the right, and now, Drake's personal branding. So now we have something in print, tangible, real. Drake and Kanye are finally putting their money where their mouths are. And so, there definitely was something on the table at some point. The next question is, what happened? Well, to understand the reason behind the album never coming out, is to understand the dynamic of Drake and Kanye's public relationship. There's plenty of content out there about the beef, Suffice it to say, the pair have a reputation for being tumultuous in the public eye. Before long, people on the internet started to put things together, realizing that maybe the collaboration was more rumor than real. Sure enough, after this, the intense, often personal, sometimes petty rivalry between Drake and Kanye appeared to flare up again, including family issues, comments about airplay, release date rivalry, diss tracks from collaborators, and more. In the end, the billboards came down, the hype fizzled out, and we heard nothing more about the project. It seems that if even the mega music industry couldn't get them together, this would definitely be a project that happened on their own terms. Kanye went on to release Ye, Jesus is King, and Donda, make waves in the fashion industry, and create his Sunday Service Choir. Drake followed up with Scorpion and Certified Lover Boy, as well as two mixtapes, and re-entered TV entertainment, this time as an executive producer. Fast forward to November 2021, and it seems that the two artists have put aside their differences. With Drake posting videos to Instagram of the two together, it appears that both artists have lost interest in their beef and squashed it, at least for now. More recently, they performed together at the Free Larry Hoover benefit, managing to reignite some optimistic fans' hope that the lost project could be resurrected. Whether we hear anything more from the pair as a collaborative force still remains to be seen. One thing is for sure, as long as both artists keep spurring each other forwards, as friends or as enemies, there'll be a lot more to see from the duo, both in and out of the studio.